good stuff.
Thank you.
All right, let's get back to that huge reported cyber attack on Iran. Joining us is Joe Caruso with Global Digital Forensics. This is the company that you call when your computers get attacked. All right, Joe, any idea how this new virus called the Flame might actually operate?
Sure. These viruses are part of what we call an advanced persistent threat. They can attack computers. They are designed by actors that could be nation states. They are sent out to gather information and sometimes give remote access into government agencies, corporations.
Is it sent out via the net?
It can be via email.
But then if Iran has nuclear facilities and you take them off the net, there is no connection between those computers in that facility and everybody else.
That's quite possible, sure.
But how do you get into it?
Well, they can also have timers set at them. They react to certain things or certain events that occur within the network may set off a future event. An internal
attack.
So they
could have gotten to those computers before they separated them from the net. Or they could have gotten to the computers themselves with some kind of time bomb, if you like, that goes off at some point in the future.
Absolutely a possibility, sure.
Now, is it possible to control this kind of virus from a remote destination in some way?
It is. It's done all the time. And that remote channel is getting more and more covert, harder to spot. They use things like RPC over HTTP, where they can talk to another computer using other servers and botnets. So very difficult to isolate those communications.
Now, we've heard that this thing is 10 times more powerful than Stuxnet. The Flame is 10 times more powerful than that old silly old Stuxnet thing. Sure. Now, how could you say that? What would make it 10 times more powerful?
I don't think you can say that. I think that technology evolves and attack vectors change and methods change. My biggest issue right now is the delivery method. You know, the spyware is getting better, but the delivery methods are getting more sophisticated.
So you don't know how they might have gotten into Iran's computers?
I don't think we know that yet.
Okay.
How about who put this thing together? Who designed it? It's described as an industrial vacuum cleaner for sensitive info. I mean, it's
yeah. Who leads
scary
the field
stuff.
In this? Is it the Americans? Who's the winner in this field?
Well, there's a lot of different actors. I mean, we do obviously have financially motivated.
Think? Who do you
are
think?
Are there like hacker celebrities out there?
There are hacker celebrities.
Yeah,
out
and is
there.
This a one man job to write this, or is this a team approach?
I think this is a team approach. This is from the descriptions that I'm hearing, is such a sophisticated threat that I don't think it's a one man effort. I think it's probably a state sponsored actor or state sponsored.
Okay, answer the question. Who are the leaders in this? Is it the Chinese? I want to know the leaders in the field of beating up somebody else's computer. Is it the Chinese? Is it America? Is it Israel? It's not the Brits, I'm sure. Who is it?
Well, you know, Chinese are certainly major players. We see a lot of
I want
threats.
Your judgment. Who's the clear winner? Who's out?
Who's number one?
Who's number
My
one?
Biggest,
best in the world?
I would say China, in
really?
My opinion. I think the Chinese have the technology, they have the desire, and they've been playing at this game longer
Please,
than a lot.
I mean, we're at least number two.
No, but what
Please.
About Israel? Because there's been a lot of speculation that this is Israel's behind this.
Look, Israel,
and we know how
high tech
they are
state,
and how much.
Any state that has to protect themselves or defend themselves needs to go to the cyber front. Mm-hmm. It's cheaper, it's faster, less people die, and really, you hit people at home, and you can do more damage than you can. You know, with an army, if you will. I mean, you can go in and attack the grid, you can attack the sewers, you can attack the subways, you can do whatever's connected to
take out airplanes.
Sure.
Take out trains.
A lot easier than you can with a bomb.
Joe Caruso, that was very interesting. Come back and tell us who really is number one. Joe Caruso, everyone, Global Digital Forensics. We appreciate you being here.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
You,
Thanks for having
Stay
me.
Stay right there for a second.